censor out of NCERT also in this chapter, like different type of deeds. In question number one, some problem.
Hello Mohit, are you getting my sound now? Mohit Panigrahi, what kind of buffering? My audio is clear now. Yes. Getting my sound now, Mohit? It's okay now? Can I start? Can I start now, Mr. Mohit? Yes? Mohit Panigrahi. Are you able to get my sound now? That's fine. Okay, that's good. So question number one, the Mills breed of cattle. You know what is Mills breed? There are three different types of breeds: Mills breed, drought breed, and general utility breeds. High milk yielding variety of cattle are called Mills breed. And we know that Gir, Sahiwal, and Devani comes in that category. So the question number first, the answer is two. That's fine. Okay, in question number two, general utility breeds, you know that cattle can be used for agricultural activity as well as milk yielding also. General utility breeds, that includes the group like Haryana, Ongole, and Kankrez. That's fine. General utility breeds can be used for both the purpose, agricultural activity as well as the milk yielding. So the answer, question number two, the answer is three. That's fine. Question number three. Viral disease of animals includes, you know, blue tongue, a kind of cattle disease that's spread by viruses only, and that is carried by insects. Blue tongue, foot and mouth, rinderpest, and rabies are all the disease caused by viruses only. The syphilitis is a kind of disease that is spread by bacteria, and that's cause inflammation in the brain. So the answer of question number three is second one. That is blue tongue, foot and mouth disease, rinderpest, and rabies. That's fine. Tell me in chapter me extra aata hai. Sometime kuch questions, few questions can be asked from the outside the syllabus also. So go through the name of few breeds, although NCERT is not mentioned any kind of that name, but you have to remember few names. That's fine. Question number four, Sunandini. You know, Sunandini is a kind of cross breed, and that is formed by the cross breed method of Indian cattle, Indian cow, with the brown Swiss or Jersey cattle, Jersey cow of the European breed. So Sunandini is a kind of cross breed with high milk yielding variety, and the answer is three. A cow formed by hybridization of Indian breed and Jersey cow. Jersey is a exotic breed, European breed. That's fine. Yes, the answer is three. Sunandini is a kind of cross breed. Although in NCERT only one cross breed name is there, that is Hisardel, but you have to remember the name Sunandini. That is a kind of crossbreed cattle. Question number five, superovulation, and that is given in NCERT. Superovulation technique is applicable for rabbit, sheep, goat, cattle. So the answer is superovulation and embryo transplantation meant for the improvement of cattle. That's for cattle, that's for livestock. Livestock includes all the economically useful animals, that sheep, goat, you know, all kind of cow, buffalo, etc. So the answer number, question number five, the answer number is The answer is second. Next question, artificial breeding of cattle is brought about by that is all kind of process can be used that may be artificial insemination. There is also superovulation technique. Homozygotic twinning is also a kind of method. So the answer is all of these. So the question number that is question number 6, the answer is all of these. That's fine. Questions are very easy, I think. You can. Llamas and alpacas are the variety of camel. These are the variety of camels. You know, llamas are present in African country, a kind of camel only. So the answer is 3. Llamas is a very known example, and they are the cattle, so that are the breeds of different cattles. So the answer is 3. Question number 7, the answer is 3, that are the breed of camels. Question number 8, selective breeding, progeny testing and improvement are taking place in, I think that is applied for all kind of cattles, that even the cattle includes the buffaloes, the goat also, the sheep also. So that the answer is first only. That's fine. Next question. By deep freezing, it is possible to preserve fetus. It is not the fetus, it's a kind of embryo. And if in the that is in the stage of blastocyst. Blastocyst can be preserved, and that is formed after 7 days, you know, so that the answer is fourth one only. If it is 7 days old, that kind of embryo can be preserved at cold temperature. So the question number 8, question number 9, the answer is fourth. That's fine. Same question, 1 week old embryo can be preserved at. So the question number 9 and 10 are very much related. If you see the answer of the 9th question, you can get the answer in 10th question only. And that is happened at cold temperature, liquid temperature. Liquid nitrogen is very cold, you know. And that kind of embryo can be stored at minus 190 degree centigrade, minus 196 degree centigrade. So the answer is 1. That's fine. Question number 11. The ova are released by hormones, induction and fertilization by artificial insemination, and then embryo is stored at 4 degree centigrade for several years. This is the technique known as, that is called preservation of embryo. What kind of hormone is injected? You know, that is FSH, that induces the superovulation process, and by that method we can make many embryo at one time only. So the answer of question number 11 is fourth only. That's fine. All are direct question, and you have to remember all these terms. Cryopreservation terms is used for preservation at cold temperature. So the answer is 2, preservation at very low temperature. That's fine. Question number 12, the answer is second. Cryopreservation word is used for the storage at cold temperature. That's fine. Mule is a kind of, you know, a kind of interspecific group. Mule is, that is the male donkey and female horse. That is also called mare. Mare. And you know that mule are a kind of sterile animal. Mule are sterile, and it is formed by the crossbreed between the, it is a kind of interspecific hybridization that is formed by the combination of the male donkey and the female horse. And the reverse of that is called hinny. Remember the last word, that E or that Y is used for females only. Like in female horse, E is there. So there is a word E. In the hinny, the last word is Y, and that's for, it is female donkey and the male horse, and all are a kind of sterile animals. So the mule is a sterile animal. Answer is 2. Random and controlled breeding are induced in the, and the answer is natural method of breeding. You know, random, that is kind of a kind of cross, you know, that is called inbreeding method. Inbreeding method, that kind of method is used. That's all are a kind of natural method of breeding. That's fine. So random and controlled breeding are included in the natural method of breeding. Next question. The sperm employed for artificial insemination of cattle are, I told you earlier, it is liquid nitrogen. That kind of storage can be done only at liquid nitrogen. That's fine. So the answer is 4th. That's fine. Name of sheep cloned for the first time is, it is Dolly. I think the year 1996 that Dolly was formed. And Polly and Molly is also a kind of cloned animal, but they are transgenic also. So remember, the first cloned animal in the world, that was Dolly in the year 1996. So the answer, question number 16, the answer is first only. That's fine. And remember, Polly and Molly also are the kind of Eve, sister Eve they are, but they are transgenic also. That's fine. 17th answer, what is that? First artificial insemination was done in India at, I think that is 4th only. It's 4th only, Allahabad Agricultural Institute. It's not the Karnal. It's the right answer. Mohit Panigrahi. It is not wrong. That's fine. And go through the history or search, you can search. It's 1. National Dairy Institute, Karnal. No, it's not the Karnal. It's not the Karnal. Go through the net and you can search it on Google also. Mohit Panigrahi. Here the answer is 4th, and that is true. Allahabad Agricultural Institute, Allahabad. That's fine. You can check once more. Superovulation and embryo transplantation technique are being used for improving, you know, that is given NCERT, sheep, goat, rabbit, cattle, everywhere we can use that technique. So the answer is 4th. That's fine. Again, the question is same. Technique of cryopreservation is used for, answer is all of these. Various tissues, we can store the embryo, the tissues, everything we can store at very cold temperature, and the answer is 4th. That's fine. So the answer number, question number 18, answer is 4th only. Exotic breeds are, yes. I told you earlier, exotic breeds like Jersey, Brown Swiss, the bull of that category are used to improve the Indian races also. So basically, they are used for cross-breeding to improve the low-quality Indian breeds. That's fine. So the answer is first, used for cross-breeding. Question number 21. I told you earlier, drought breeds are those breeds of cattle that are used for agricultural activities. Question number, sir, why not 4? In which question? Remember, exotic breeds are not disease resistant, but they are very good in milk yielding quality. Indian breeds are, Indian cattle are more resistant to disease, but they have poor milk yielding capacity. So that's why we use that exotic breeds to improve our Indian low quality yielding breeds. The answer is first only. Drought breeds are those kind of cattle that are used for agricultural activities. So they are good working bullocks. That's fine. Drought breeds produces, answer is 2. That's fine. Question number 21. Question 22. Which of the following has been recently used for increasing productivity of super milch cow? I think all are the techniques that is used, embryo transplantation, super ovulation techniques, all techniques are used for the improvement of milch cow. You know, milch cow means more milk yielding varieties cow. So the answer is 4. Next one, the branch of biology. What is milch? Milch means cattle with very good milk yielding capacity. I told you earlier, Gir, Sahiwal, Devani, as a kind of Indian breeds of cattle with very good milk yielding capacity. Milch means good milk yielding capacity. That's fine. The branch of biology dealing with the process of improvement of human race by selective breeding is called, that is the part of eugenics. Euthenics is the improvement of functional activity, functional parts of the human beings, and euphenics is the improvement of phenotypes, and that obstetrics is the part of childbirth process. So the answer is 2, eugenics. That's fine. In 23, the answer is 2. That is called eugenics. If it is phenotype improvement, that is called euphenics. The functional improvement is the part of euthenics. That's fine. Question number 24. The transgenic animals are those which have, you know, foreign DNA in all its cells. Transgenic means animal with genes of different animals. So transgenic means foreign DNA in all its cells. That's fine. Question number 25. Which set of beneficial insect to man? Human beings, you know, honeybee, the lac insect, and this cochineal insect, all are very useful kind of insect, because you know, the wasp is of no use. It's a harmful kind of insect. And the cockroach, it is also a harmful kind of insect. Sandfly causes disease, you know, that is Phyllobutomus argentipes. That causes kalajar also. Cochineal insect, I think that is a kind of insect that is used to get some kind of useful product. So the answer is first only. You can even eliminate the answer in that 4 options, because the wasp is harmful, the cockroach is harmful, and the sand fly is also harmful. So by the elimination, we can get the answer, and that is 1. That's fine. Question number 26. Match the following. That's a very simple question. Bombyx mori is a kind of silk insect that is that feeds on the mulberry plant. You know, the caterpillar of silkworm feeds on mulberry plant, and we get the good quality silk. So Bombyx mori is related to mulberry plant, and that's why that silk is also called mulberry silk. That's fine. Morus alba, Greenwich is the part of second one. That is the center where silkworm eggs are produced and supplied. And powdery mildew, a kind of disease of mulberry. So the answer is 2. That's fine. The question number 28. That's fine. 27. Nobel Prize winner. You know, that name was Von Frisch, who discovered the honeybee dance and a continuous study of that dance pattern, and finally he concluded that dance pattern explained about the source, the distance of the source food from the nearby part. So the Von Frisch was also awarded with Nobel Prize for that discovery. Honeybee dance is a kind of honeybee behavior, and that is a very important kind of behavior that is used by honeybee insect to inform other insect about the distance of the food source. That's fine. The answer is first. The honeybee exhibit a type of dance to communicate the location of food. This is known as both kind of dance they perform. If the food is within 100 meter or beyond the 100 meter, and that is round dance and waggle dance. So the answer is third one. Round dance and waggle dance is a different pattern of dance performed by the scout bees to communicate other bees about the source food. So the answer is three. Both kind of dance they perform, round dance as well as the waggle dance. So the answer is three, not the one. Freshwater fishes which have a great food value, you know, rohu, katla, clarius, because hilsa is a kind of marine fish, second can't be answered. And salmon is also a marine fish. The answer is one, rohu, katla, clarius, that is magur, and the mistis. Common carp, that is given NCERT also, that name. So the answer, 29 answer is first only. And gambusia is a kind of very economical kind of fish that is used to feed on mosquito larvae. So gambusia is a predator of mosquito larvae. Answer is first. That's fine. So the question is very easy, I think. But you have to remember few names of the, you know, name of breeds. Cryopreservation technique is also very important for you. So go through these terms also. That's fine. Answer is one. Anything else? Question number 11. What is that? 11 dikhaiye ma'am. Question number 11. The ova are released by hormone induction and fertilization by artificial insemination, and then embryo is stored at 4 degrees centigrade for several years. This is the technique known as preservation of embryo. Question number kya hai iska? 11. Yes, that technique is used for preservation of embryo. You know, after the formation of embryo, that embryo can be stored for several years, and whenever we require, that embryo can be transplanted to the surrogate mother, and that embryo can be developed. So that is a part of embryo preservation. The answer is fourth only. 17 is very confusing. It's showing different answer in different source in Truman's. It's option 2. And question number 17, dikhaiye ma'am, kya hai? 17. A first artificial insemination was done in India at. Right now, I am sorry about Allahabad Agricultural Institute, but I will see once more. But you can go through the different sources. That's not a very difficult question. You can get the answer from a different source also. That's fine. I will check it also, if it may be. But right now, the answer is fourth only. Why preserve mosquito's larvae? Where there is no need to preserve mosquito larva. If mosquito larva is present in water body, that larva can be easily fed by the gambusia fish. So we can spread the, prevent the spreading of mosquitoes by killing the mosquito's larvae. Callus is a kind of tissue culture. Callus is a kind of tissue culture only. That's fine. Homozygotic twins. Simple. This is all about identical twins. If a zygote is divided into two different forms, if you talk about identical twins, it is similar like homozygotic twins. After the formation of zygote, if that zygote is divided into two different forms, all zygotes are similar and they are called homozygotic twins. In human beings, we use the term identical twins. Yes, it is undifferentiated mass of cells that can be further differentiated into tissues also. Heterosis, vigor. You know, if you crossing between the two different breeds, heterozygous superiority is always there. That's fine. Anything else? So the animal husbandry is not very, very important if you talk about the neat point of view. But one, at least one question can be asked by the breeding process, inbreeding method, outbreeding method, crossbreeding method. So at least one question can be asked from this area, animal husbandry chapter, basically not from the cattle's breed name, but by the knowing different methods of breeding. So you must remember inbreeding, outbreeding, outcrossing, interspecific hybridization, as well as the Moid process. Thank you.